Hello everybody, Camelia here. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I have to share my latest make, a pair of pajamas, jersey pajamas from Made with Pattern Jolly 4016, made in a really gorgeous cotton jersey from Minerva. And also, if you stick around at the end of the video, I will show you how to make how I finished the back of the neckline of the top. And you see something really easy, but it's giving a really, really cool, nice, you know, like ready to wear kind of finishing. So starting with the pattern, I really needed pajamas. I keep making dresses and stuff like that, but really I need some housewear and also some nightwear, like jersey pajamas. I really love them to have them in the night on. So I knew that Jolly, they had this pattern. I think it's called GN or Jean. Anyway, I made this for Lisa. Is the cool thing about the Jolly patterns is that they have really a lot of sizes, from starting with size size 92, that will be for 2 years old, and going all the way to adults like size 56, or ready to wear a bit to compare with 2XL. So I had this pattern because I made it a while ago for Lisa, and you know, you can print all the sizes, but you can also, with Jolly, they offer the possibility, of course, to print layers. So I only printed the sizes that you know, Lisa, her current size at that time, and then up to my biggest size. And then every time I need one, I'm only tracing the size I need, so I keep this intact. And you know, when Lisa is growing, I can make her again a bigger size. I don't think I'm going to grow so much, so I have only my size, the biggest one here. I'll put it later in. So for myself, I never made a top from Jolly for myself. I did make some pants in the past. So I went, because I knew it's a pajama, I was thinking I'm not going to make a test garment for it. So I looked at the measurements and I decided to go for the top. I went with my bust measurement, and for the pants I went, because I have different sizes, for the pants I went with my, let me see if I remember correct, and I don't want to say it wrong, for the pants I went with my waist measurement, because I knew that the hips measurements in that size are a little bit larger than mine, but I was thinking I want them to be a little bit roomy, because I know that also from seeing other versions on the internet and from how the ones for Lisa came out, that there is a pretty not snug, but it's not very wide, the pant. I mean, it's not like a legging, but you know what I mean. So, and actually you can also see on the technical drawing here that is really a pretty fitted pant. I mean, being in a jersey like this is of course still very comfortable. So with that in mind, and because I again I didn't know exactly my size in Jolly, I did measure the pattern a little bit, and I decided, you know, to be on the safe side, I decided to add on the pants from the waist all the way down to the hem. Let me see if I can see it here. I decided to add, if you can see, to add like 1 centimeter from the waist all the way to the hem. And I also added on the inseam, on the inside the leg seam, I also added 1 centimeter, so gave it a little bit more room in case that it was too snug. But actually, that, to be honest, even without it, was it would have been a really perfect pajama pant. But with this, I have a little bit more room. You see it in the pictures. I think the fit is really great. So I added 1 centimeter from the waist down to the hem. For the blouse, I knew that the neck is really pretty high, it's coming till here, including the binding or the small band that is getting attached at the neckline. So I decided that I wanted a little bit lower. And for that, you see in the picture that I have a little bit more skin showing, let's say, in comparison with the ones that Lisa is wearing, you see here in the picture. Other than that, oh, and because of the blouse, I also knew from Lisa that is a little bit straight and also pretty fitted on the hips, let's say. I wanted to have a little bit more room there, I didn't want that, you know, to float. So to do that, I decided to add, let me see, this is the front, and as you can see, I decided here at the hem, let me measure, I added 2 centimeters at the hem here and went in a straight line to nothing here at the armhole seam. So, and that gave me this really nice, a little bit like an A shape, A shape here at the hem, and it's really very, very, very comfortable because it has a little bit more room and it's hanging free from my body. So that was the change that the changes that I made for the blouse, lowering the neckline, as you can see, and also making it a little bit wider at the hem. For the neckline, the first time I was thinking to put a piece of binding. This is a really soft ribbing that I used. Initially, I was thinking just to make a hem, to make everything longer, instead of the bands, to make the sleeves and the pants a little bit longer and just make a hem. But then I discovered this ribbing in my stash, and I think it's really nice because the pajama is the cuffs are keeping everything nice and snug. So I use this, and I really wanted to use the same for the neckline. And then I got the idea to use my binder, or what is the name, you know, the thing that you put a piece of binding in it and you do it with a cover stitch, to use that binder to put the ribbing on my blouse. But the problem is that, because I think this is a little bit too thick for that binder, it worked, but the problem was that that stretched while I was sewing with the cover stitch, and of course everything got a little bit eased in, and it was again very tight here on my neck, and I didn't want to have that. So I just ripped it off, and I had to unpick my neck band because it was really terrible. It was not terrible, but it was really in my neck again. And I just cut a piece of ribbing. I decided I want to have like 1 centimeter showing, and I knew that I will use a 6 millimeter seam allowance. So I made the binding. I cut a piece of 3.2, I think it was, wide. There is a piece of there is a piece of binding for the neck, but I never cut those things because, I mean, usually I go with what I want. And I just make it, I don't know anymore how much percent I did choose to make it shorter, but I think it was 90% or something like that. But then I did walk it a little bit around my neckline to see if I like it, how shorter it was, and decided on to make just a little bit more shorter, and it's really perfect. Attach it with the serger, didn't bother to change the threads, but it's laying really nice and really flat, because I think the narrower the band is, the better is laying flat on the body. And so this was done. This is a really fast project. I mean, I was in no time done with it. And I really wanted to finish the back of the neckline, you know, because usually you see where you start with your serger. Of course, you can start somewhere at the shoulder, but usually I start at the center back. Then you see all those threads there. So I decided to add a small band, which is really, really easy. And I'm going to show you in a few minutes here at the end. I'm going to show you how I did this. It's really, really easy, and it's done with the sewing machine. Of course, there are many ways to do this, but I'm just going to show you how I did mine. And I actually it's looking really, really great. I love it. So this was my my jolly pajama. I'm really happy with it. For the pants, of course, I added some elastic. Also, I think this is a bit wider than what they call for, but I don't know. I added what I had on hand. I have a really big roll with this elastic, which is like 3 centimeters, and they ask for 2.5. And I added with my serger. Sew it on, then turn it to the inside and stitch it with a zigzag stitch. And to be sure that I'm not going to look for the back and the front every time I put it on, I just made a little tag here from a piece of jersey to be sure that I can find it really, really easy when I put it on. So this was also really easy and fun to make. The cuffs are also added with the serger. Just quartered them and then quartered the pant leg and put it on. Also very, very easy. The next, I'm going to make another one, but I'm going to make it for Lisa. This is a piece, I'm always keeping a piece of what I used with the pattern in the plastic sleeve like this, because I recognize it very fast if I see the piece of fabric what it was. And for this I'm going to make also a pair, maybe also to change something in the blouse, or you know, with the pants you cannot do so much, but maybe also her pants a little bit wider, and add something in the blouse to make them a little bit more fun. But who needs fun when you have this kind of fabric to work with? Because this one is really, really fun. It's such a happy fabric. I get love every time I see this. So this is also from Minerva. It's a really nice fabric, and I'm going to make her a pair of pyjamas from this one. I only need to decide what kind of ribbing I should use. I think this is going to be difficult. I need to buy something because I don't have either purple or a dark pink, or maybe like a green or even blue. That's fun because I can go either way. So this is going to be the next make with Jolly 4016. I'm going to put the tutorial on how to make the neckband. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments. Or of a dress, or you know, in my case, the like I did it on my pajama top. So I have here, this is not my pajama top, this is a dress I made in a cotton jersey, and this is the back neck seam. You can see here where I started adding the binding, or the band is actually a neck band. And here I have a piece of jersey that I'm going to use to cover this seam. I have here the band is cutted on the greatest stretch of the, this is also a cotton jersey, and I cut it. I have here my seam allowance on my garment is 6 millimeters, so I want to cover this, so I'll need 2 times the seam allowance, because the band is getting folded, is getting attached on the right side, let's say, and then I'm going to flip it like this, and I'm going to cover the seam. So I need to have 2 times the seam allowance, because this is getting folded, 2 times the seam allowance, that will be 1.2 centimeters, and of course another 1.2, so 6 millimeters when it's folded, to cover my seam. And I just have a longer piece of it. I'm not cutting it on what I need here, but I'm making it just longer, and actually it's really easy. You can do this also when you are putting your neck band immediately, or you can do it after you serged the neck band on your garment, then you can go again and serge this also. But I think it's a lot of thread that is really not necessary to put it in. So the next step is, let's see, this is my garment. And now I need to sew my band, And I'm starting always just a little bit inside the, this is the shoulder seam. So this is my my back neckline, of course, and I'm starting just a little bit in. I see some people going over to the front, over the shoulder seam a little bit, but I'm doing it only on the back. So I'm starting maybe 1 centimeter from the shoulder seam. And I see here that my shoulder seam should be actually sewn to the back, but I did not pay attention, and it's sewn to the front. So I'm going to, this is folded, it's pressed, and I'm not starting exactly at the end of my band. I let a little bit of a tail, and I'm going to place it here. And I like to be sure that I'm covering these stitches. I like to sew from the back, so with the band against my the plate of the machine. So I'm putting it here, but I'm going to flip it to be able to see the stitches. So I'm putting it like this, and of course I have absolutely no pin here. No, I don't have, but I really don't need one. So I'm putting it in the machine. And you know, if you want to be sure that your band is wide enough, so you need 2 times for the seam allowance, 1.2, and another 1.2 for the to cover the seam. I'm so 2.4. I do it like 2.6 or something like this centimeters to be sure that I have enough fold to go over the seam. Now I'm going to put it here, and let's see. Okay, and I want to sew exactly on this left needle of my serger to be sure that I'm covering the seam. And you see here is the band, the raw edges, or the raw edges of my band. My band is against the raw edge or the serged edge. And I'm going to meet this, or maybe just like a millimeter inside, to be sure that I keep enough band. So I'm putting it like this. I'm just going to sew with a regular stitch. Let's see if I'm on that like this. I'm on the needle line. Maybe a little bit of back stitching won't hurt. And you don't need to stretch anything, also the band knot, and also your garment. Everything needs to be 101. So just sew till you get almost to the other part of your, to the other side of your neckline. And if you wonder about stretching, as you can see in this dress, I also used some stay tape to be sure that it's not going to overstretch the back of my neckline. So in this case, because maybe you are wondering, I'm using a straight stitch, but this really is just enough stretch kept that you know, to put this over my head. And if you do have, but usually you have like a little bit open neckline when you do this. And if you do worry about the stretchiness, instead of using this straight stitch on your sewing machine, you can definitely go one time more with your serger and apply this band with your serger. Okay, I'm almost there. Let's see, just a tiny bit in. And of course I need to follow my wonky serging if I did go a little bit wonky. And you can see here I have maybe, let's see, 1 centimeter now. Just a little bit of back stitching. Take this out. And I'm going to take a peek to see what I have. This needs to be cut. And let's see. So this is from the back. As you can see, I followed the left needle of the, you can see the lines a little bit darker. And this is how it's looking from the other side. And now the idea is to go to the pressing table and bring this down. And as you can see, you get already a really nice finish. So I'm going to press this off camera because it's not so exciting to see. You almost don't need to press this. So the idea is that you are covering this. And of course you get on the other side a piece, a little bit, a line of straight stitching. So this is at the end. And I'm going to cut this just a little bit, or let just a little bit, maybe like, I don't know, a centimeter or something like that. Let's see, and I can do something. I see sometimes it's also by ready to wear, they just, or they fold it or something like that. You see, you just fold it in, and then I can cut it a little bit, even a little bit shorter, maybe lesser than 1 centimeter. You fold it, and then take a little bit of this bulk away, and then you do it like this. And you need to be careful when you put it like this down. You need to be sure that you don't get here like an ugly fold. So you need to work it with your fingers, that on both sides that seam is getting nice and flat. You need to fiddle a little bit with it. No, I'm not even going to press. I hope I don't mess up, because this is a dress I really like. It's I don't know the name anymore. It's a dress I made with, and you can start here first with a vertical line of stitching, like this. Let's see. And really try to arrange everything. I'm going to push this a little bit inside. Okay, just a few stitches here. Let me see, this is not my regular machine, but I think it's working fine. I'm going to pull those straight to the back when I'm done. Maybe with my hand. I need to be really, I need to be at the edge, and I think I'm okay. So I'm going to turn it now. I'm going to pull a little bit my neck band away, and on the same time I'm going to pull the band here to cover everything, and I'm just going to stitch. And you really need to stitch just shy from that fold of the band you just added. It's really handy if you use thread. For fabric you can use whatever here, because normally you should not see this from the other side. But it's important to use a matching thread in your bobbin to match your fabric, your outer fabric. Let's see. Maybe it's also nice to use something that is matching this fabric that you are using for your band. Okay, this is something you need to take your time, because you really, even if you pin this, I think the best is to work it every few centimeters, or every centimeter almost, to be sure that everything is getting covered and you get no puckers or stuff like that. So this is the finished neckband. As you can see here, you can really see the threads from the serger picking, but because I used white serging thread when I attached my original neckband, it was better to use dark. But the idea is to try, best as you can to go on that last left needle on your original stitching, and then you have no of these little stitches picking out. But if you use a dark thread, or not a dark thread but a matching thread, that it will be the best. So here you can see it from the inside. Is I used a brown thread, but if you use something really matching with your fabric, you'll only see a small ridge here from top stitching the band. Here I'm starting just before the shoulder seam, and also I'm ending just before the other shoulder seam, and I think this is really, really beautiful. It's a really nice touch. You can, of course, you can have fun with different fabrics. That makes it even more fun. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and I hope you found it helpful. It's a really nice and very easy detail that you can add to your knit patterns or knit makes, let's say, that is giving a really nice touch and a really nice finishing, and I think it's something that you can easily try. It's really not so difficult. Thank you so much for watching. Please push the subscribe button and put your notifications on to see next videos here on the channel. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please give me thumbs up and share it with your sewing friends. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Bye.